lesson, I'd like us to have a moment of prayer.
Heavenly Father, thank you so much for bringing us all together on this day. Thank you for waking us up this morning. Thank you for putting clothes on our back, food on our tables, and a roof over our head, Father God. I just want to ask that you will decrease me so that you can be increased, Lord, and help me to bring this word unto your people. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Yesterday, we talked about how we are freed from fear, thanks to Jesus Christ. He died on the cross so that all of our sins may be forgiven, but we still have special obligations or duties to uphold as Christians so that we may be heirs to the heavenly kingdom. In today's lesson, we're going to talk about how you can be adopted into God's family, but first we're going to go over some vocabulary words. The first word is adopt, and this word is one's taking care of a child who is not biologically his or her offspring as his or her own. So throughout the week, you'll hear about a lot of different people who were adopted as we go through our lessons. The second word is predestined. Predestined means to plan something beforehand. In today's lesson, we're going to be covering Ephesians chapter 1, verses 1 through 10. And the first three verses read, Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, to God's holy people in Ephesus, the faithful in Christ Jesus, grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in the heavenly realms with every spiritual blessing in Christ. This was a letter written by Paul to the people in the city of Ephesus, as we can see in verse 1. In verse 3, we're told that God has blessed us with spiritual blessings. And if we want to get a better picture of what these spiritual blessings are, we have to keep reading, because the answers are in the next few lines of this scripture. Verses 4 through 6 read, For he chose us in him before the creation of the world to be holy and blameless in his sight. In love, he predestined us for adoption to sonship through Jesus Christ, in accordance with his pleasure and will. To the praise of his glorious grace, which he has freely given us in the one he loves. The first spiritual blessing is that God chose us to be holy and blameless. Blameless means innocent of wrongdoing. So consider our discussion from yesterday. Jesus frees us from fear of our sins. We know that we can repent and our sins will be forgiven. And God did all of this even before the creation of the world. Isn't it amazing to know that God chose to give us grace and offer us salvation, or offered us Jesus before we were even created? That's a love like none other. In verse 5, we can find our second spiritual blessing. God predestined us to be his children. We are heirs to the heavenly kingdom, just like we talked about yesterday. When we believe in the gospel, which is believing and accepting Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, knowing that he died on the cross for you to wash away your sins, you are adopted into the family of God. Now, you don't have to stop there. You can also be baptized at your local church, and I strongly encourage you to reach out to your pastor if that is something that you would like to do. Or you could even comment on this Facebook Live, and we're always looking to expand the family of God. Our third spiritual blessing can be found in verse 6. God has freely given us grace. Grace is when God looks at us favorably, and he does this because the blood of Christ has removed or taken away the guilt of our sins, so we can be accepted by God in his image. Ephesians 7 through 10 are the next verses that we're going to focus on, and they read, In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins in accordance with the riches of God's grace, that he lavished on us. With all wisdom and understanding, he made known to us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure, which purposed in Christ, to be put into effect when the times reach their fulfillment, to bring to unity all things in heaven and on earth under Christ. Verse 7 leads us to our fourth spiritual blessing. We have been redeemed for our sins through the blood of Jesus. Redemption means free, so we are freed from punishment of our sins, thanks to Jesus, and our sins are forgiven as well. And our fifth spiritual blessing is that God gave us wisdom and understanding through his word. He told us his plans. The word tells us that all things will be brought into unity through Christ, and we will see that in full effect when the times reach their fulfillment. So in today's lesson, we talked about the spiritual blessings that God has for us, and I've pulled out some of the key points that I truly want you to remember. The first is that we were always in God's plans, even before the earth was created. We are predestined to be a part of God's family, and you can be adopted into God's family through the acceptance of Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. God has given us grace even though we are imperfect. It's already predestined that Christ will be returning to bring unity to all things in heaven and on earth under Christ. Thank you so much for joining me today. I'll catch you again tomorrow, same time, same place.